Whether you agree with it or not, our first story is sure to get you talking. We're looking at gender in sport.
Because there's been a whole lot of brouhaha over Hawke's Bay girl Briar Hales. Remember her? She was told she couldn't play in a boys' rugby team as part of a local tournament.
Well, it's fair to say opinions been divided about whether it was the right call or not, with parents, politicians and even sports stars weighing in.
But what about if the shoe, be it rugby started or not, was on the other foot?
A boy who's not allowed to play in school league netball. Jill goes courtside.
A Blackburn scoring rugby player of the year. Female cricketers making a run for pay parity. Women winning the fight to box professionally. It's fair to say equality in sport is looking good.
Hey, what about netball?
Loads of girls play netball.
Exactly. I'm a boy, so I can't play.
Now, that's a blow. 13-year-old Braden Sycamore's from Gisborne, where netball's pretty popular, except, it seems, with boys his age. But Braden has competed happily for 3 years.
I just love the high action and, yeah, it's really fun.
Which is great, because his team wanted him.
I was just like, oh, no, I'm still going to play him. He's on my team.
And other teams didn't mind him.
Every time we've asked if he can play, most of the teams are fine with it, especially if the option is either playing or being short.
But Gisborne Netball says they can't have him. Because despite saying this...
We are here to provide a platform of sport for all.
They're now saying this.
They're allowed to play up to year 8, as in the Netball New Zealand rulings, but as far as secondary goes, we're not going to start changing rules. That's one thing as a board that we do not do.
Little stink, because they're encouraging you from year 7 to, like, to play, yeah. And then as soon as you get to year 9, it stops.
A little bit any other sports?
Didn't really enjoy rugby, because I honestly sucked at it. Soccer, never really enjoyed that, and I can't shoot, so basketball was out of the question.
Now, Braden's school requested an exception a couple of weeks before this year's season started.
At that AGM meeting, they were very pro-boys' development and pathways for boys, so it looked like it was going to be positive, but then when they went to the closed meeting and then the decision came out that it was a no.
It would break rules. So if we break one rule, where do you stop?
Well, we don't always like to play referee, but... we're not sure it would be rule-breaking, because while Netball New Zealand does say that boys over the age of 12 can be discriminated against, it also says that this is only if the strength, stamina or physique is relevant.
And Braden doesn't mind admitting it's not. He only made the B team after all.
Oh yeah.
I'm a little taller than most of them, but not much. They're all probably stronger than me.
This week, the New Zealand men's netball team will take on the Silver Ferns. Their coach admitted the result's too hard to call because in this game, all sorts of skills count.
It's all about body speed and the way you move and the passing of the ball. Definitely in the circles, it might be a little bit of advantage if he was 6 or 7 foot tall, but I presume he's not.
And it's surely even truer for younger players.
I don't think he would have any advantages over us.
We don't think it's fair Braden can't play, but if you don't want to take our word for it, just ask his team.
BS! Not cool. Ridiculous.
Sexist.
Wrong.
What harm would it actually do?
I think the harm would be that we just need to be sure that when we introduce anything new that we're very transparent with our whole fraternity.
So, not much then.
And I'm wondering if that would happen if it was a girl playing a boys' sport. So I think there's got to be a little bit of equal opportunity there for everyone, and it's probably for the boys' best interest that he does play.
Well, Gisborne Netball says it just needs more boys and more time.
I think it's great that he's brought this to the table. It has been on our table for a while.
For a while? How much more time do they need? Meanwhile, they say Braden's had other opportunities like beach netball training and refereeing.
He did pick up a whistle last Saturday, I heard, as an umpire, which is fantastic, and I'd endorse that. But at the moment, I'm sorry for Braden, it's just the way it has to be.
So no place on the team for Braden, but he's still got his voice.
Put in a mixed league. We want to play. Just, yeah, get over yourselves.
Oh,
What disappoints me with this is you've got a teenage boy here who's desperate to play sport and he has been told that he can't. I just think it's ridiculous that you should tell any child who wants to play a sport that they can't.
I agree with her. Now, I'll tell you what's really interesting. Other regions are looking at you, Nelson and Dunedin. You've previously used your discretion, now there's a thing, to allow boys to play so it can and has been done before. Mm,
exactly. But until Gisborne Netball chooses to bend their rules, there's no court action for Braden. But I've got some really good news. New Zealand Netball are giving him tickets to see the New Zealand men's team take on the Silver Ferns, which will be a sensational match.
Yes.
And the men's team are flying him to Auckland to train with their under-23 men's squad.
Now, Braden's and especially excited to be able to actually take part in some on-court action rather than sitting on the sideline or umpiring. Mm.